Hello students, we are going to start the second chapter of chemistry today, and the second chapter of chemistry is about metals and non-metals, and this forms the basis of study of chemistry for higher classes. So you have to study this part very well. It's nothing new that you don't know about what metals and non-metals are. You know about them. We will have a discussion of this part, and we will discuss today that how we can differentiate between metals and non-metals on the basis of their physical property. So what is a metal? If we think about our daily life, we use many kind of things. We have got iron grill at our windows. We have got iron, you can say, bucket in your washroom. Besides that, we use copper wire for electricity. So there are many kinds of metals which are present around us. Aluminium is a very commonly known metal which is used to make utensils. It's present in your kitchen. So if aluminium is not there, then we have got alloys of aluminium, or we have got alloys of iron, which is stainless steel. So there are many kinds of metals that we use in our daily life. Besides that, we have got many kinds of non-metals also that we are using in our daily life and we are not knowing about it. The first non-metal is oxygen, that without oxygen we cannot survive. So there are around 118 elements known to us so far, and out of them, most of them are metals and very few of them are non-metals. So what are the non-metals? Oxygen, hydrogen, carbon, phosphorus. Phosphorus is present in the matchstick. Okay, chlorine gas. Chlorine gas you must have smelled many times due to it is the gas which is coming out from the bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is a common chemical which is common disinfectant which is used as at home. So if you pour water to bleaching powder, or when bleaching powder absorbs moisture from atmosphere, a pungent smell comes out from it, and this pungent smell is because of chlorine gas. So chlorine gas is used as disinfectant. It is also used for treatment of water treatment. You know that many villages and all people simply sprinkle bleaching powder into well to disinfect it. So these are the materials, and this whatever substances are known to us are either classified as metals or non-metals. As I told you that 118 elements are known to us, and among this 118 elements, most of them are classified as metals because they possess certain properties. So today we are going to differentiate between metals and non-metals on the basis of physical property. Now the question must come to your mind that I have been using the word physical property, and what could be the other property? Other property could be chemical property. So what is the difference between them? How we will come to know that these properties are physical properties and the other properties are chemical properties? So it's very easy. If you do not need to change the composition of a substance, like if you want to study the property of water, like solubility, you will add some substance to it and you will study that whether it is dissolving or not. Or if you want to study the melting point of water, boiling point of water, you don't need to change the composition of water. If you heat water, if you boil water, it still remains water. It does not change into any other substance. So those properties of the substances which can be studied without bringing any chemical, without bringing any change in composition of the substance, are known as physical properties. But there are certain properties which cannot be studied without changing its composition, and such type of properties are known as chemical properties. So in this video we will only be discussing about physical properties of metals and non-metals. So let's start. I will discuss it in the tabular form. On one side I will write metals, on another side I will write non-metals. Okay, so what are the properties? Metals are hard solids. solid. They are hard solids. You have seen an iron, how hard it is. You have seen aluminium, how hard it is. So metals are hard substances, whereas non-metals are soft solids. Solids or gases, they can even be liquid. They have low melting point. If it is a solid, it will have a low melting point. That means it will melt at very low temperature. Whereas some metals are hard solids with very high melting point. Melting point. You have seen that iron does not melt so easily. Aluminium does not melt so easily. You have to heat a lot. And when the temperature will rise to the melting point, only then they will melt into liquid. Second, they are good conductors of electricity. That means they allow electricity to pass through them. They are good conductors of electricity. Poor conductor of electricity. Both electricity and heat. Poor conductors of heat and electricity. Similarly, heat and electricity. Metals allow heat and electricity to pass through them. You have seen that if you take a spoon, if you will heat it at one end of the spoon, the other end of the spoon also becomes hot. But this is not true with non-metals. They are poor conductor of electricity. They are also poor conductor of heat. That is why you have seen that plastic covering, the rubber, the electric wire has got rubber covering on it. Why? People advise you that when you are operating an electric appliance, you should wear rubber slipper, and rubber slippers are insulator. They do not allow the electricity to pass through them. So what is a poor conductor? One does not, anything that does not allow electricity to pass through them is known as poor conductor or insulator of current. Now what I told you, know that air is mixture of gases. It has got carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen. Nitrogen is also a non-metal. So if air is, 78% of air is made up of nitrogen, around 21% is made up of oxygen. So if I take a wire, if I plug into the switch and I just keep it, the naked wire with the covering, of course I will be holding with the covering, but that naked, if I just simply keep that wire in air, and if you are standing in front of it, will you get electric shock? No, you will not get electric shock. Why you will not get electric shock is that because air is an insulator of current. It is not allowing current to pass through it. Though air is made up of oxygen and nitrogen, the major part of air is oxygen and nitrogen, but still you are not getting electric shock because non-metals are insulator or poor conductors of electricity. Next topic is on the basis of ductility. What is ductility? Now you have to see this. The property of metals by which it can be drawn into wires is known as ductility. So property of ductility. Metals are ductile. Malleability. That means they can be beaten into sheets. You have seen iron sheet. You have seen tin sheet. Tin is also a metal. If you beat it, you keep on hammering it, it will get flattened, and that is the property of a metal. They are malleable. The verb is malleable and noun form is malleability. Ductility or ductile. Metals are ductile. They can be drawn into thin wires. You have seen copper wires, which are present in electric cables. So Copper wire is present in electric cable because copper is a good conductor of electricity, and since it can be drawn into wire, so this being drawn into wire is known as ductility. Being beaten into sheet is known as malleability. So they show the property of ductility, malleability. They are non-ductile. They cannot be drawn into wire. They are non-malleable. Non-metals are non-malleable. They cannot be beaten into sheet. They are brittle. What do you mean by brittle? Brittle means if you hammer it, it will break into pieces. But if you hammer iron, it will not break into pieces. But if you have got a brick, if you hammer it, brick breaks into pieces. It does not get flattened. So brittle means the one that breaks into pieces upon hammering. Malleable means one that will get flattened upon hammering. So non-metals are non-malleable, they are non-ductile, whereas metals are, they show the property of ductility, they show the property of malleability. Another is being sonorous. They are sonorous. Metals are sonorous. What do you mean by being sonorous? Sonorous means they produce sound upon being hitting. When you hit a metal, they will produce sound. So you have seen that their bells are all made up of metals. Whether it's an electric bell or the manual bell that you ring it, they all produce large sound, or you can say loud sound. The large is not a proper word, loud sound. And why they produce loud sound? Because of the property of being sonorous. But non-metals are not sonorous. Not sonorous. Even if you hit it, they will not produce sound. So non-sonorous, they are, metals are sonorous. Good conductors, we have already discussed. So these are the major properties, physical properties on the basis of which we can differentiate a metal from a non-metal. So can you just pause the video for a moment and can you think of some more properties of the physical properties of metals and non-metals which can be used to differentiate between them? Otherwise, that's all for today. We will be continuing with the chapter in the